Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is another one where I'm using rocks that were bumpy or pitted or beautiful and I wanted to save them and I used leftover resin to seal them and I'm going to paint on them later. So you guys saw this in one of my recent videos. It's pretty easy to paint on top of resined rocks once they're cured, but you have to use a Sharpie if you want to mark anything down. Someone mentioned using an erasable Sharpie, which I currently don't have. My son has erasable markers, but they are window markers and they will not fit in my my circle maker into my compass. So I'm using permanent marker to make circles on a couple of stones. I'm going to show you how it is on a non-resin stone as well. I've added glitter in my resin on this one, so if you see it sparkle, that's not the natural stone. I have also doing one on a natural stone that hasn't been resined so that you know exactly how it's going to turn out depending on the surface that you're working with. You can also do this on handmade art stones using molds where you make your own stones. And yeah, it's going to look amazing when we are done because I'm trying a very new technique. So once you get a circle, find anything to make a circle and try and keep a center dot in the center so that you have something to work with a little bit later. Just a little trick. You don't have to use resin stones. As you can see, I'm using some that aren't resined. And we're going to make some beautiful antique flowers. I'm going to be using a crackle medium. So it's actually Folkart crackle medium. And I got mine at Michael's online because I can't find anything in a store right now because we are locked down. So yeah, I bought crackle medium online. I believe it was like $12.99. at Michael's. You don't have to use the same brand as me, but this is the only kind I've used so far, so this is the only kind I can teach you how to use, okay? So turn your circle black. I used a little finger sponge to get a nice even texture of black paint. It's matte black. I'm doing also a gold outline. And I'm keeping my center dot. I put a little gold dot there. We're going to be covering that up, but I need to know where that center is so that I can make my flower. If you clicked on this video because of the picture, let me know what you think. Let me know what you think of them. If you are new here, welcome. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thank you. Welcome and paint with me for free. I have over 200 tutorials. And I love it all. I love it. It's my passion. So you saw me do it on a resin stone already, but I'm just using like a natural stone here. It's going to look a lot different once I seal it with resin, and I can't wait to show you at the end with the resin reveal. I'm doing the same thing. I drew my circle on with pencil this time. Because there's no resin on it, I can actually see my pencil line. You can use like whatever it is that you use to mark up your stones, you use that. It's totally up to you. I just like to use a pencil when I'm using natural stone and then a marker when I use resin stones because then I can see it. And then I'm dabbing it, making sure that I have it outlined in gold and then outlined in black. I'm doing a second coat so that you can't see through any of it. You want to make sure you have a nice thick coat of matte black paint there. I have never used it on satin coat or any other kind. I just use acrylic matte paint most of the time. So I'm just teaching you what I've taught myself so far. I'm willing to accept any tips and tricks with Crackle Art in the comments below. So please share any stuff that you know, because I'm new here. I'm new here. So now that the black paint is completely dry, make sure you let it dry for at least an hour. Then we are going to brush on a nice layer of the Crackle, Folkart Crackle Medium, which I just showed you the bottle there. It goes on clear, it dries clear. You'll be able to see a difference in it once it's dry, but definitely let it dry. There's gonna be a lot of drying time with this. Just be aware. You have to let it dry properly so that so that we can do our work on top of it. So you'll start to see it kind of drying as I'm painting them on, but they're going to look really different when I've let them dry for about 2 hours. I hate waiting, but you know, that's just the way things have to go. So there, that's what they look like. They're still kind of glossy, but not quite shiny. And they're dry to the touch. They're not sticky. Well, there might be a little bit tacky, but not too tacky. Welcome to Rachel's Rocks vocabulary. Too tacky. Now I'm going to be using a variety of different colors today to show you just different ideas, because you might not like the colors that I choose or whatever. So I thought I'd give us a couple of different flavors to work with. I'm starting this one off. It's a very light colored stone. It's not going to change its color when I seal it again. This is as dark as the stone's going to get because it's already been sealed with resin. Now you can see that paint is immediately aging. It's immediately starting to crack. The thicker the paint you do, the longer it's going to take to not only dry, but to crackle properly. Oh, one moment, please. If you're new to Rachel's Rocks, you should be fairly warned that I do get notifications during my recordings. That is life. And I have a strange little giggle that people get annoyed by. So I can't help it. I giggle. So I started with white, then I lightened a light daffodil yellow with a little bit of white, and now I'm going to go in with pure daffodil yellow and do a third row of petals once those ones dry a little bit more. And while they're drying, I'm doing a very thin line of gold around my petals, just very, very gently. Sometimes it's not even, my paintbrush is kind of skipping over and it's not getting like a smooth line all the way around. I don't care about that. I'm just kind of adding a little skiff of gold. There's another Rachel's Rocks vocabulary, a skiff of gold. I believe that's some kind of boat. Now I'm using moon yellow. So this is darker than the daffodil yellow. It's nice and bold, and I'm doing a thicker layer of it because you have to kind of do a thicker layer over top because that crackle paint moves around a little bit underneath. So do a thicker layer. When those are dry, I can do some gold around those as well. Now I did that fast. I'm going to be doing the same exact thing with this one. I'm just choosing a different color because there's kind of like peaches and reds. It's a really beautiful stone. So I'm going to use some magenta, and I'm going to use some, I believe, some pink melon and some coral. And that's going to make for a beautiful color on top of that beautiful backdrop. Once again, I'm doing the gold outline while the petals are drying, and I'm being not careful. You don't have to be careful. If you go outside the lines, that's okay. Don't worry about that. While that set of petals are drying, I'm going to do purple. I'm going to do three different shades of purple. It's going to be lavender, light lavender, and wisteria. I always list all of my paint colors and brands in the description of the video, as you know. Same with the paintbrush that I'm using. I have a tutorial for that, the really fine line one. I also have resin tutorials and all other sorts of tutorials. Make sure you take a look at my video list and share. Share away, because painting is therapy and people need therapy right now. I'm telling you, we all need a little bit of therapy right now, art therapy. So, doing the same steps, I'm just kind of using lighter colors on top of lighter colors that kind of go together. So, yellows and whites and magenta and coral and pink. It looks beautiful. And they instantly start crackling. But like I said, if you're using a thicker layer, it takes longer. So make sure you let them dry for a few hours, I would say, to make sure that you're seeing the full effect before you seal them with whatever you decide to seal them with. I will be sealing mine with resin as usual. It's my favorite. And I will show you the resin reveal at the end where you fall in love. I fall in love with them every time I see them resin, so I know you will too. So everything's being outlined one at a time. I do a set of petals, then I outline it with gold, then I move over to the next rock. If you're only doing one, then you got to go get yourself a coffee or something. Get yourself a bevy and relax because you have some waiting time. It does dry fast. Acrylic paint does crackle quickly. But I hate waiting for these layers to dry. So I do more than one at a time so that I have something to do. So now on top of my lavender and light lavender, you guys know my favorite color is purple. So this is like probably going to be one of my favorites. I'm using wisteria now, which is a very, very, very light purple. And it's gorgeous. So this one is almost done. All those center petals are crackling nicely. I'm using a pink chair, nail brush, but I use it for painting because they were nice enough to gift me a beautiful set of paint brushes and they're amazing. Basically, it's a blending brush and I just sponged on a little bit of black paint in the center like I'm doing now. And then I will add a little bit of gold paint and then we're going to add a little bit of glitter. Of course, because that's what I do to all of my stones. People are shocked when they see one of my tutorials and there isn't gold or glitter in it. They're actually like questioning if I'm okay. I'm okay. It'll be overboard in the next tutorial, I promise. So I have done a green one as well on the natural stone. Just three different shades of green. That's it. Same process. They all look beautiful. You could do the multicolored rainbows or whatever. It's up to you. I'm going to use a little bit of chrome powder. It's a very, very fine nail powder. And it's like so sparkly. It's like goldish green. You don't have to use that. You can put whatever kind of glitter you want in the center or you can just leave it black and gold. It's up to you. You do you. And then I'm putting a little dab of, you can use Mod Podge or you can use Triple Thick. It's like a paint on gloss or glaze. And that just kind of holds the glitter in place where I want it to stay. So I'm let it dry and I have now resined it and let it sleep in resin baths overnight. And they're touchable and shiny enough that I can handle them without getting my fingerprints on them and ruining them. It's hard for me still after years of using resin to not touch them when I see them because they are so shiny. I love shiny. So this rock, oh, it matches so nicely with the background. What beautiful, beautiful stones to begin with. That's why I saved them because I wanted to paint something special on them. So yeah, I really like this crackle stuff. I'd love for you guys to let me know in the comments what you think. Thank you so much for painting with me again today. I'm trying really hard to get tutorials out on a schedule. It may not go that way, but I'm trying. And I'm homeschooling. And we just had a huge flood in our basement. And it wasn't just because of like winter thaw. Look at that purple. Yeah, it was a bad flood, and we paid a lot of money this past weekend. It was not a fun weekend. But yes, today is Monday, and I have flowers with color and glitter and sparkle, and I hope that something in this video brought a smile to your face. I'm going to show you the green one. Look at that stone. Look how much it changed. It's gorgeous. It's a Lake Superior stone. Look at Lake Superior beauty right here in my hand. I feel blessed. Oh my gosh, that is gorgeous. And I love that color. That's beautiful too. The crackle, my husband just is in awe over this crackle effect. And honestly, I got it my inspiration from a tin can, a tin, like a cookie tin or a tea tin from England. That had flowers that were crackled and I fell in love. This one is definitely my favorite. That's why it was chosen for the thumbnail. Three shades of blue, baby. That's all you got to do. Three shades of blue. And these look fantastic on any kind of stone, any shape of stone, as long as you can put a circle on it and do this, you are good to go. And you don't even have to go get crackle medium. If you Google ways to make paint crackle, there are different ways you can do it, I believe, with like Elmer's glue and stuff like that. But this stuff is great, and it's a big bottle, and it lasts a long time. So see if you can find Folkart crackle medium. And it's fun. It's so fun. But you have to sandwich the Folkart crackle medium between paints. So you have to put a base coat of paint underneath the crackle medium. And then the crackle doesn't work until you paint over top of the dried crackle medium. And there's a nice little handmade art stone right there in the center with beautiful dots and a beautiful purple flower. I'm even making some foam grips. Hello. And those are going to be beautiful. I will be posting pictures on my Rachel's Rocks page. You guys know that. Sorry for all the commotion in the background. That's my beautiful family. I love you guys. I hope you've enjoyed this. Let me know what you think and let me know what color you're going to try. I will see you soon. Keep painting, guys. Love you.